Hello students, in your advanced organic chemistry, rearrangement reactions are an important part, and every year there are a number of questions asked from this particular section. So in this video, I'm going to take the very first name reaction or the rearrangement, pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement. And in every next video, I'm going to take all the important rearrangement reactions which are very important for your entrance exams as well as your college exams. So let's start. What do you expect from this video? You should be able to do these kind of questions once you are through with the concept. They look very difficult right now, but once the concept is yours, these questions are nothing. So we will come back to this. First of all, let us know what is a pinacol. A pinacol is any molecule with adjacent carbon having OH group attached to it. So here you can see that the adjacent carbon have OH group attached to it. This is one of the example. And what is a pinacolone? A pinacolone is formed when a pinacol is treated with a dilute or a less concentrated acid. So one of the carbon gets converted to carbonyl group and there is some rearrangement occurring, right? So when a pinacol is treated with a dilute acid, rearrangement occurs leading to formation of a ketone. What kind of rearrangement you can see? Here, this carbon has 2 methyl group. This carbon also has 2 methyl group. But here, this carbon now has 3 methyl group, right? So some kind of migration must have occurred. So remember, pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement comes under this category where the migration is occurring to the electron deficient carbon, or we can say carbocation rearrangement is occurring, right? Okay. Now, another 2 important thing, mechanism and the key points. Let us see how the mechanism is taking place. Here you can see that the H positive ion, which has come from the dilute acid, the lone pair of the OH will attack on this H positive. This is always happening. In your earlier classes, you have studied this. The lone pair of the oxygen attacks the H positive and oxygen gets the positive charge. Then the water comes out and the carbon gets the positive charge. Now at this particular point, when carbon has the positive charge, we have 2 alkyl group on the adjacent carbon. One of the alkyl group will migrate. It will migrate to this carbon, forming this transition state, and then finally you can see here that the methyl group has migrated and this carbon gets the positive charge, the one which has the OH group. Because the carbon has the positive charge, the lone pair from the oxygen forms the double bond. Oxygen gets the positive charge now and the H positive comes out, forming this ketone. So this is the mechanism. One thing that you should know is that you already might be knowing because you have done it in your earlier classes, that H positive which has reacted here is not the same H positive which has been released, right? Okay. Next point is these 3 important things. It is an intramolecular rearrangement. No crossover product is formed. So if you have 2 pinacol reacting together, both the pinacol will react separately, the products formed will be separate, and there will be no crossover product or mixture of products will not be obtained, right? So because this is an intramolecular rearrangement, remember. Second is carbocation generation is facilitated by the group that increases the stability of the carbocation. This is very obvious that carbocation will be formed so that its stability is there. When the stability is not there, the carbocation will be formed in such a way so that stability has occurred in that case. And the most important is migration occurs to a due to a stable octet formation. Now this is very, very important. Why? Look at this particular intermediate. Here you have this carbon already tertiary carbocation. When this is already a tertiary carbocation, why there is a need of a migration occurring? Why this migration has occurred to this carbon? Why this is formation? Why the formation of this pinacolone taking place? The reason is This particular intermediate is more stable as compared to this intermediate. Reason, because of the formation of stable octate. In this particular intermediate, all the carbon have their octate complete compared to this one. Because here, this carbon has not its octate complete. It only has 6 electrons. That is why this is the driving force for why this reaction is occurring. So, this migration occurs because after the migration, this intermediate is formed which is more stable. Now, after this, you know that the H positive will come out and we will get a ketone. So, this migration occurs, you should know what is the driving force for the migration. The reason is formation of stable octate, right? Okay. Now, before we come to the migratory aptitude, if you are only interested in what is pinacol, pinacolone and what is the mechanism, this video is enough for you. But if you have some more questions in your mind, for example, if instead of methyl, I change it to phenyl, your question should be, out of phenyl and methyl, which will get migrated here? That should be your question. So, such kind of question will be answered by knowing what is the migratory aptitude. Migratory aptitude is the ease with which any particular group will undergo nucleophilic 1-2 shift. So this is 1-2 shift occurring, right? A group from carbon number 1 goes to the carbon number 2. What is the migratory aptitude? So the list is very long, but I have included just few which are very, very common. Like out of phenyl, hydrogen and methyl, phenyl has the highest migratory aptitude, then comes hydrogen, then comes methyl. And if you compare, if there is an electron releasing group attached, the migratory aptitude is even higher, right? So, if I take this particular case, here, if you see this particular intermediate, because see, the H positive has attacked and H2O has come out, so this is the carbocation. Now the question is, out of this methyl and phenyl, which is going to get migrated? The answer is, according to this, the answer is phenyl. So you can see here, both the phenyl has come to the same carbon. Now at this carbon, the positive charge has come and the lone pair will form the double bond, and then you know what to do, right? Remember this example because you are going to see it later in the video. Now, another thing. This particular is a symmetrical pinacol, isn't it or not? What if there is an unsymmetrical pinacol? Something like this. If you see this one, this carbon has both phenyl group, this carbon has both methyl group. My question is, first question, which of the OH will attack the H positive? Because here the environment is unsymmetrical. Now, some of you will form this intermediate, some of you will form this intermediate. The answer is, this intermediate will not form. Why you will like to form this intermediate? Because your answer is that if this particular intermediate will be formed, because phenyl has more migratory aptitude than methyl, it will migrate here. But no, this is not the case. Here, the migratory aptitude is the second point. First point is the carbocation stability that I already have told you. Carbocation stability is more important. So, if you compare this carbocation with this carbocation, you will see this carbocation is more stable. Why? Because when this OH comes out and the positive charge is here at this carbon, because of these phenyl group, two phenyl group, this particular intermediate gets more stabilized. So your answer should be, this carbon gets the positive charge having the phenyl group. Now out of these two methyl, one will get migrated here and this product will be formed. Right? Okay. Now there are some very closely related reactions similar to pinacol, pinacolone rearrangement. From here onwards, we have all the important reactions I'm going to discuss, so you can take them as an example of pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement. This is an epoxide ring opening, as you can see. So here the epoxide ring opening is taking place, MgBr2 in the presence of an MgBr2. The carbon, the positive charge will come to this carbon. It is a symmetrical molecule, as you can see, so the positive charge can come to any of these two carbon. Now here, what you have to do is, because this bond will come to between carbon and oxygen to form the ketone, so the question is, out of hydrogen and phenyl, which will migrate to this carbon? The answer is phenyl, because the migratory aptitude of phenyl is higher than hydrogen. So we will have something like this as the product. Okay, another one is, if you have, instead of OH, you have chlorine, right? So in the presence of Ag positive, this chlorine will come out and we will have a positive charge here. Now again the question is, at this at these adjacent carbon we have phenyl and methyl. So phenyl has a higher migratory aptitude than methyl. This will attack here and you can see the product formed. Another one, very important. Instead of chlorine you have NH2. So in the presence of a nitrous acid, HNO2, what will happen? The diazo group will be formed. This diazo group will then come out in the form of N2 nitrogen gas. Carbon will get the positive charge here, similar to this one. Same, this intermediate will be formed, and this intermediate will then rearrange to form this product. So we are going to get the same product here also. Here we use a term called semi-pinacol rearrangement. What happens is that if instead of OH you have a good leaving group, for example iodo, diazo, tosyl, so here you can see that you have a good leaving group because it is coming out as N2. So whenever there is a leaving group at the beta carbon, because the carbon to which the OH is attached, which is going to be formed as a ketone, if this is considered as an alpha carbon, the adjacent one is the beta carbon. To beta carbon, if there is a good leaving group attached, then it is going to follow the same kind of a mechanism as that of the pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement, but we have the reactant bit different from the pinacol, so we called it as semi-pinacol rearrangement. So these three are important reactions or important examples you can keep it in mind. Now we have the same examples I told you in the first slide, that these are the questions and you will be able to do all these questions. Now I would like you to see these questions and can you do this question by yourself? I told you to remember a particular example, because this particular is the one which we have already done before, isn't it or not? So I am not going to do this because we have already discussed it. You can go through. Okay, this one is, this is also a symmetrical case. Here we have phenyl and a methoxyphenyl at this carbon. Again here we have a phenyl and a methoxyphenyl at this carbon. Now you know it. So the H positive will attack on any of the two OH, and we will have a positive charge. For example, if the OH comes out, it will form it will come out as H2O. Okay, so here we will have a positive charge. Now out of phenyl and methoxyphenyl, which will have a good migratory aptitude, so this is going to be migrated. As I told you, the when phenyl group has an electron releasing group attached to it, it will have even a higher migratory aptitude. So this will get migrated here, and in the product you can see that the same carbon has both methoxyphenyl group attached to it, and the other carbon gets the ketonic group, right? Okay. Example third and fourth is the case of ring expansion. So we will do it in detail. I would like you to see the fifth example. Here we have the mixture of reactant. I told you, if we have mixture of pinacol, no worry. We know that the reaction mechanism follows an intramolecular rearrangement. So if there is an intramolecular rearrangement, then what will happen? This will give its own product, this will give its own product. There is no mixture of product going to form. And we have already done it. This is similar to the first one. So you can do it. Instead of methyl, if you have ethyl, This is again going to be going to give you the product, desired product. So they are not going to form any mixture of product. So this is also easy to do. So we are going to do the third and the fourth case, and let us see how the ring expansion is occurring, right? In the third case, what is happening? The H positive attack will occur here. The lone pair will attack of the oxygen will attack at the H positive. But the question again is which of the OH, because this is an unsymmetrical molecule, as you can see. So which of the OH will come out in the form of H2O? Of course, this one. Why? Because the positive charge will be formed here, and in the presence of two phenyl group, this will be highly stabilized. Okay. Now, at this particular carbon positive, this bond will, or this particular carbon will attack here, and there will be a ring expansion occurring. When the ring expansion occurs, the positive charge goes to the carbon to which the OH is attached, right? And then you know what is happening. The lone pair will come here to give the double bond, and then the oxygen gets the positive charge, so the H positive will come out, and we will have this as the product. So here the ring expansion has occurred. And if similarly you follow the same, you will have such kind of a product in case of example number four. So here I close this video, because I think this much is enough for you to know what is a pinacol-pinaclone rearrangement, how the mechanism is taking place, and all the important examples I have covered. So if you have any doubt, write me in the comment box. Otherwise, if it is somewhat useful for you, subscribe to the channel. All the very best. We will meet in the next video. Thank you.